A lot has happened since the last time we spoke. The zombie apocalypse is now less than a week away. But the good news is that we got our food, medical supplies, and we even managed to get water. In fact, we even got our pipes fixed, so now they work a lot faster. But it comes with a catch. We have one last tank of water to fill, and now one of our pipes is leaking, and it's draining out the water. Let me show you. The inlet pipe to a large water tank can fill the tank in 25 minutes. The drain of the tank can empty it in 55 minutes. Once, the drain was left open by mistake when the tank was being filled. The mistake was not caught until the tank was full. To the nearest tenth of a minute, how long does it take to fill the tank? Now, let's jump into this problem. As you can see, here is our last water tank. As we fill the pipe, there's a problem. There's also a drainage. But before we jump into this issue, to solve the problem, let's take an example. Here we have an empty tank of water. Suppose we're given this information that this tank can be filled in a total of 5 minutes. Well, how much of this tank can be filled in 1 minute? How do we do that? First, we can start by either taking a proportion through algebra or using a visual representation. Let's start by understanding how to take a proportion. Here, I've set a proportion. I have one tank, which is equal to 5 minutes, or the amount of time it would take to fill it. I want to know how much of the tank can be filled in 1 minute. We can divide both sides of this equation by 5. 5 divided by 5 would give us 1 minute, and 1 divided by 5, or 1/5, would give us how much of the tank can be filled in 1 minute. We can also use a visual representation. Suppose we divide this tank into 5 equal parts, as you can see here. Well, how much of this tank could be filled in 1 minute? 1/5 of this tank could be filled in 1 minute. We can see this as there are 5 equal parts, and this full tank can be filled in a total of 5 minutes. Therefore, for every minute, 1/5 of this tank, or 1 of these 5 parts, can be filled. Now that we've understood this example, let's go back to the original issue and fix our water tank. The information we are given here is how long it will take to fill the tank, 25 minutes. And how long it will take to empty the tank if the drain is on, 55 minutes. So let's start by seeing how much of the tank can be both filled and emptied individually in 1 minute. We know one tank can be filled in 25 minutes. So how much can be filled in 1 minute? Again, we can go back to our example problem. In that problem, we were given that a full tank can be filled in 5 minutes. And when seeing how much of the tank could be filled in 1 minute, we saw that 1/5 of it could be. We did this by doing 1 over the total amount of time it took, which was 5 minutes, hence 1/5. We can apply this to the same question. We can do 1 over the total time it took, 25 minutes, hence 1 over 25. Therefore, 1 over 1/25 parts of the tank can be filled in 1 minute. Now that we know this, let's see how much of the tank can be emptied in 1 minute. We know that in 55 minutes, one tank can be emptied. And therefore, by doing 1 over the total amount of time it took, 55 minutes, we can see that 1 over 55 parts of the tank can be emptied in 1 minute. This tank and the water in it shows how much can be filled in 1 minute. This tank shows how much of the water will be drained in 1 minute. Now that we've seen these visuals, let's go back and understand what the problem is and what we need to find. Keep in mind that these visuals are not drawn to scale. As we can see, the question is asking how long it will take to fill the tank if both the filling pipe as well as a draining pipe are on at the same time. So first, let's start by seeing how much water would remain in 1 minute if both the filling and the draining pipe are on at the same time. How do we find that? All we have to do is subtract the amount of water that was filled in 1 minute minus the amount of water that was drained from the pipe in 1 minute. Hence, we can do 1 over 25, the amount of water filled in 1 minute, minus 1 over 55, the amount of water drained in 1 minute. We can find a common denominator using the least common multiple, which we can simplify down to 12 over 550 or 6 over 275. Well, what does this mean? This shows us that in 1 minute, 6 over 275 parts of the tank are remaining. We can see this through this visual. By subtracting the amount of water filled in the tank minus the amount of water that was drained, we have 6 over 275 parts of the tank remaining. Well, what does this mean? If we divide this tank into 275 tiny portions throughout, 6 of those 275 portions would remain in 1 minute. Now that we know how much of the water would remain in the tank in 1 minute, we need to find how many minutes it would take to have a full tank. We can do this by taking the proportion. As we have to go from 6 divided by 275 parts to 1 full part or 1 full tank, there has to be something that we must multiply to get 1. We can do this by multiplying the reciprocal or the flip of this fraction. Therefore, we can multiply 6 divided by 275 times 275 divided by 6 to get 1 full tank. And whatever we do on the right side of the equation, we also have to do on the left side of the equation. As we multiplied 275 divided by 6 here, we have to multiply 1 minute by the same value. Therefore, we can see that in 275 divided by 6 minutes, we will have a full tank. We can divide or simplify this fraction further down, and we know that in 45.8 minutes, we can fill 1 full tank. Looks like we have a lot of time.